New this morning, opinions are split on the success of President Obama's State of the Union address. Democrats, as you might expect, applauding the president's commitment to his plan, while Republicans say he is unwilling to compromise.
Susan McGinnis takes a look at what the president promised in his speech as he gets ready to take his proposals on the road.
But tonight, we turn the page.
In his sixth State of the Union address, President Obama called on the new Republican-led Congress to help the middle class with proposals they are sure to vote down, including tax hikes for the wealthy, free college tuition, and raising the minimum wage.
If you truly believe you could work full-time and support a family on less than $15,000 a year, try it.
He asked Congress to authorize the use of military force against ISIS in Iraq and Syria and to pass laws to protect Americans from cyber terror.
No hacker should be able to shut down our networks, steal our trade secrets, or invade the privacy of American families.
While promising to work with Republicans, he also threatened to stop any attempts to unravel his actions on health care, immigration, and financial reform.
If a bill comes to my desk that tries to do any of these things, I will veto it.
Republicans criticized the president's proposals before he even gave the speech and continued afterwards.
He is squandering the last opportunity to set things right with the American people.
In the official Republican response, newly elected Senator Joni Ernst of Iowa hinted the new Congress will be different.
Congress is back to work on your behalf, ready to make Washington focus on your concerns again.
The president heads to Idaho today to push his proposals. Susan McGinnis, CBS News, Washington.
And the reaction right here from Idaho's congressional delegation was predictably negative. Criticism focused especially on the president's economic proposals.
Since the president was first elected, our national debt has grown over 70% to an amazing $18 trillion. And yet tonight, the president is proposing a budget that will increase spending in Washington by another 7%.
The glowing picture painted by the president ignores the most important number to families today, and that is that the average family earns about $3,000 less each year now than when the president took office.
Congressman Mike Simpson was also critical of the president's speech. He released a statement saying, in part, quote, "The president touts his free federal programs, while Republicans know that free federal help places an additional strain on America's already overburdened taxpayers." And Congressman Raul Labrador says this about the president, quote, "He glosses over the fact that the middle class has suffered greatly during his 6 years in office. The president now proposes tax and spend policies he couldn't get passed in his first 2 years in office when Democrats controlled both houses of Congress."
And reaction from Boise residents was a little more mixed, with some people saying they felt positive about the president's speech. As Boise prepares for a visit from President Obama, Jacqueline Powell tells us there are a couple of key issues Idahoans hope the president will speak about.
President Obama's State of the Union address aired over several screens and a loudspeaker in BSU's sub. And those who showed up to watch say this speech seemed different than those in the past.
This time he seemed much more relaxed and much more willing to compromise. I think that's going to resonate with a lot more people this time around.
This audience says compromise is key. They like the idea of our government working across party lines. They also say a couple of the president's points in particular stand out because they're important issues in Idaho right now, namely raising the minimum wage and creating fairness for the LGBT community.
I think that's some of those things have been put off for a long period of time, and the fact that it actually is being addressed, and just recently in the state itself, like, you know, gay marriage, you know, the approval, you know, and the fact that he's coming here and speaking openly about it, I think that's going to play a big role.
Those watching say they believe the way the president went about this speech will make for more receptive Idahoans and Americans in general.
I thought it was very important for him to focus less on policy and focus more on more of a united America. He mentioned a lot of, this isn't a conservative country, this isn't a liberal country, this is a united country. So I thought it was important to focus on that instead of the policy. That's when he starts talking about policy, that's when we become more and more divided.
This viewer says he hopes the president also shies away from policy while speaking at BSU as well, and focuses more on ways to make Idaho an even better place to live moving forward.
Jacqueline Powell, KBOI News, Boise.